Hello, welcome to the Zebra BI for Power BI product update. The new versions of Zebra BI charts and cards are live, and we are excited to show you the improvements. Note, the product update for the tables visual will be covered in a separate video once it's available on AppSource. Now, without further ado, let's take a look at Zebra BI charts and cards upgrades. With Zebra BI charts, we are gradually moving all possible settings onto the visual interface to save you from constantly searching for them in the global format pane. In this version, we are delivering a huge package for categories, legends, and stack charts, and others will follow in subsequent releases. Let me show you where to find them. To access the new category settings, move your pointer to the categories, and a blue outline will appear. By clicking anywhere on the categories area, you now open the category settings. Here you can customize the axis font by clicking on the toggle, where you can adjust the font size, and the color. You can also adjust the handling of long labels in the dropdown or the axis label density by selecting every nth or the first and last. Lastly, you can now adjust the gap between the columns also directly on the visual by just simply entering it here. Once you're done, simply click outside of the settings box to hide it. Legend settings can also be accessed by simply hovering over the legend area with your mouse pointer and clicking within the blue outline. Here you will find a toggle to switch between comparison measures, which reverses the previous year and plan display. Next, you can adjust the margin between the legend and the rest of the visual. And you also have a toggle to use aliases as tooltips. Now, turning this on with the default names will do nothing in the tooltip. But if, for instance, we rename the plan to budget and previous year to last year, now with the setting turned on, we will also see this displayed in the tooltip. If you want to keep the IBCS abbreviations, you simply turn this to off and you keep the IBCS abbreviations also in the tooltip. Again, to close the legend, you simply click outside of the box. Stack chart settings are now also easier to find and adjust. Simply move to the legend and click to bring up the settings. You can easily adjust the color and even the number of n stacks by simply writing it in. You can adjust also the labels directly here. Same holds true for stack charts with vertical primary axis. You can even rename the others label to something more appropriate, maybe rest of the world in this case. You can still highlight individual stacks then by simply clicking on the dropdown. Additionally, you can adjust the category text width on the vertical axis. So click on it to bring up the settings, and then you can select within full or fixed width to adjust. We believe these gradual improvements make the user experience much better, as you don't have to search for every specific setting in the global setting, and it is much clearer what you are adjusting. We have added an automatic highlight in the last data point mode of the Zebra BI cards. The cards visual currently has three display modes. You can either show the total sum, including the forecasted values, the year-to-date display for incomplete periods, which compares only the sum of the actual values with the corresponding sum in comparison measures, and the last category mode, which shows the last actual value and its comparisons. Allow me to demonstrate the usage. So you can select the mode if you go into the global settings under format and card, and under comparison options, you can choose the mode directly. But for individual cards, you can also seamlessly switch by simply clicking on the main value. Now, to improve the clarity of the mode where we display just this last data point, that value now automatically gets highlighted in the built-in charts. The mode is useful for display of non-additive measures, such as averages, balances, and so on. So let me bring up an example. So here we have a group of KPIs, and we simply want to highlight the last average for the revenues per customer. So now when we click on this mode, the highlight immediately indicates what we're displaying also in the main value. The new highlight addition now should provide your decision makers with better clarity and faster understanding of the designated KPI value. Thank you for tuning in to our product update. We hope you like the upgrades. For more news on tables and upcoming releases, follow us on social media. Also, make sure to check out the changelog on our website for a complete list of improvements and bug fixes. Thank you for your ongoing support, and see you in the next update.